Do my baby booze and welcome back to the channel. And if you're new here, hey hi, how are you? What it do? My name is Alyssa and I am the girl with the plumbob tattoo. Welcome to the channel. So today we are building the Ink and Paint Club. If you've never heard of it, it is actually the club in Who Framed Roger Rabbit, where you see Jessica perform for the first time and the detective kind of sees her for the first time. And this is where, you know, he takes those scandalous pictures of her playing patty cake. I thought that this was going to be really fun. To be honest, it was kind of a headache and a half. I was really trying to like work with the platforms and everything, but the platforms are so annoying, to be honest. I actually cut out a lot of footage of me really struggling with this front room, because if you've seen the movie Who Framed Roger Rabbit, and you know, you go to the scene of him walking into the club after, you know, he has to say the password and everything, because I think this is kind of like some sort of like old speakeasy or something, but you have to say a password in order to enter it. But once you go through that first room, there was supposed to be like a staircase that he goes down, and it's like a really like run down room. It's not supposed to look like that cute or anything, but he goes down these stairs, and I've tried so hard to put some stairs down there and like make the platform go lower, but then in order for that platform to go low, you had to have, you know, stairs to go back up, or yeah, to go back up to like the main like level, because you know, it's just complicated. It was just complicated. And so I cut out a lot of footage so that I could make it work. I ended up just not having many stairs in that front room, but it took a long time for me to like get to that conclusion. I thought it was gonna be really fun. I really did, but it was like such a headache. yeah, so this is for my History Legacy Challenge, if you haven't already kind of guessed that. We're going to be meeting Jessica here. I don't want to say too much about like what my plans are or anything. Honestly, I don't really have many plans for Jessica and Everett, but basically he's going to run into her, and I think I'm gonna have him move to either Del Sol Valley or San Myshuno. And if he moves to Del Sol Valley, I'm kind of thinking of maybe like having San Myshuno just kind of be like an extension of you know, LA or something, like downtown LA. As long as it's not winter, maybe we could pull it off. But yeah, I want him to be living in some kind of like apartment, and then have him kind of like, honestly, okay, this is my plans for him. I do want him to get into like the police force when he gets a little older. The war is coming up right now though, so that's kind of like the next thing that we have to worry about, is him and any like boy of age, like his dad, Arlo, to kind of get ready for war. We're gonna end up having them go and fight in World War II. This is gonna be insane. I've never had a sim fight in a war before, but we're gonna make it work. After the war though, he is going to hopefully survive and hopefully become a detective. That's just my hopes for it though. I want him to get into the police biz. So I think he's gonna run into Jessica Rabbit with, you know, the whole mystery of her husband, you know, whatever. I don't wanna say too much. I don't wanna say too much. But anyways, this was interesting to make. It was just really interesting. I only had like a few seconds of footage from Who Framed Jessica Rabbit to really like work with when it came to building the stage and like the whole Ink and Paint Club. And the only thing that really kind of irked me about this build, well, one of many things actually that kind of irked me about this build, was also the fact that you enter through like this alleyway. So like the entry isn't on the outside where, you know, cars would see it and everything. That's why I think it's kind of like a speakeasy kind of building. Maybe like they pose it as like a warehouse on the outside to like, you know, people who wouldn't, you know otherwise. But like you enter through this alleyway, and the outside of it is just going to be plain, because You know, there's no doorways, there's no windows, there's literally nothing that you can put on the outside of it. So I ended up putting like this like theater thing on the outside of it, you know, like that light up thing that attaches to the wall. And then I also put some like garage doors on there. It just kind of looks like a warehouse from the other side of it. So we were hoping, I was hoping that that would, you know, help the aesthetic of it, but it's not really that aesthetically pleasing from the outside. Just the alleyway. I really like the alleyway. I ended up putting a lot of trash and like making it kind of like pleasing for me. And I really liked how in the movie they kind of had it looking like trashy. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I don't know. I really ended up kind of liking the build in the inside, at least. It was all right. I didn't really have many places like in the movie where you can like see where the bar is or how it's handled, so I kind of ended up winging it. So I just put in the Star Wars bar because it's curved and it takes up a lot of room, and you know, it makes for a busier kind of room. I had a lot of room that I didn't know what to do with, so I almost forgot about bathrooms until the end too. So I ended up putting bathrooms behind this room that I didn't really know what to do with anyways. So that worked out for me. And there were a lot of tables in the movie, so I ended up putting a ton of tables down. More tables than I think Sims will even come into. I also have this mod where, you know, people won't come in from other worlds, so I'll have to fill up Sand My Shuno to make it, you know, so like more people will come, because every time I try recording the inside of it and, you know, show it off and everything, there's like two or three Sims that are even there, because I don't have many people in San Myshuno to, you know, show off or anything. So I'm thinking I'm gonna fill up the worlds. Maybe that'll be the next thing I do before I record again. And either way, I'm not gonna be like showing off this build in the next episode or anything. I just like to get builds done ahead of time so that I can just jump into the gameplay when I'm ready. But I thought that this turned out a lot better than I thought it was going to. For a while there, I was thinking I was just gonna trash the game. I actually ended up getting really irritated and split it up because I just got off the computer. I was like, I'm done. I can't figure this out. Like, I thought this was the perfect lot, you know, to place it at, you know, like right next to the apartment buildings and everything. But it was really small for my taste, like, because I had to elongate it where the stage was, but it just didn't have enough space for like that whole alley part. And then, you know, the stage is really long and it comes out really far. If you've ever seen Who Framed Roger Rabbit, you would understand. But I worked with what I had, and I think it ended up a little bit better than what I expected for it to end up. But yeah, so I ended up making Jessica Rabbit dressing room, which is my absolute favorite room. I love it, and she is just so cute. If you saw the last video, like from either yesterday or the day before, I just think she's actually really pretty. I'm excited to show it off in a Let's Play. I put a lot of work and time and effort into this Let's Play, so it really means a lot to me that you guys actually watch it. Like, it's really, I think it's the only thing that actually keeps my Sims channel going, is the fact that people are watching it and supporting me, and you really mean way more to me than you might think. Like, it really means a lot that I have people actually watching this channel and watching my videos. It's not about the views either. Like, one person accused me a while back that I only work on videos if they're getting views and everything. And while that's important to me, because, you know, this is my way to make money, one of them, it's not as important as you may think. It's just the fact that I put a lot of hard work and effort into everything that I do on this channel. Like, I don't just, I don't know, record and we're good. Like, I actually sit down days or weeks before I record the final video, and I set up the set, I make all the people, I write storylines down in my Google Docs. I work really, really hard on every single aspect, so it really just means so much to me that you guys are actually here supporting me and watching my content. So thank you so, so much for all of your support. With that said, I do have a funny story to tell you while we're here just kind of watching this. I haven't been like on here for a couple weeks, it feels like it's been a really long time, but I had this story that happened a little while ago that I thought was actually really funny and, you know, kind of appropriate to tell during a speed build since I have nothing else to talk about. Okay, so there was this one day, like a couple weeks ago, where we didn't have any milk and my husband is a huge milk drinker. And so his uncle asked him, you know, he texted him. He said, hey, do you guys need any milk? I have this extra milk that I don't know what to do with and I can just drop it off. And my husband was like, oh, sure. Yeah, we do kind of need some milk, actually. Matter of fact. So yeah, like after work, you can come over and drop off the milk. Meanwhile, I was at home taking a nap and I wake up and there was nobody home but me and my little brother. My little brother has Down syndrome. He's not, you know, bringing friends over or anything. And I wake up from my nap, go into the kitchen, and there's 12 jugs, 12 gallons, whole gallons of milk sitting in the kitchen in boxes, like for a box. And the door was locked and my brother's in his room and I'm just like, what in the world? Why is there milk? And it was cold, so it was like it wasn't there for very long. It made me feel like someone like burglarized my house and instead of taking anything, they left stuff. It was so bizarre. And so I called my mom and she said she didn't know, you know, what was going on. And she was just as baffled as I was. So then I called my husband and I'm like, yo, why is there 12 gallons of milk in the kitchen? And they weren't in the fridge or anything. It was just on the floor of the kitchen in boxes. And my husband was like, dang it, he was supposed to, you know, contact me after work. It wasn't supposed to be during. And I was like, oh, so you know what's going on. So he told me, you know, what happened with his uncle. And I'm just like, dude. And then come to find out, like last night or the night before, it happened again, dude. He didn't come in this time. Oh, by the way, the way he got in the time before was because my brother let him in and then locked the door behind him. But this last time, my husband came home to find 16 gallons of milk in our yard. In our yard. And so before you guys yell at me or anything about wasting, I actually went on my Facebook page for my city and I ended up like giving it away. So like we gave away like 6 gallons the time before and then we had 6 left in the fridge and then I was just giving them away to my family as they came over because that was just too much. Like we have 4 people living in this house, like not enough to drink 12 damn gallons of milk. Anyways, so we ended up having to do it again. Like my husband just gave it away to people like damn t-shirts at a baseball game, just like popping them out of a little like t-shirt gun or whatever. But yeah, so I thought that was kind of funny, but it's just so dumb. Like, come on, dude. Like, why is this my responsibility to give away milk? Oh man. Anyways, I thought that was kind of funny. But anywho, we are kind of nearing the end of the build. I worked on Jessica Rabbit's room. That was my favorite. What my favorite part of that room is I actually had this mannequin that I've had in my game for a little while. It's just a mannequin with a red dress on it, but I thought it actually worked really well for her room because it's like, you know, she can put her dress on there whenever she's not performing and like maybe she wears something different when she's out and about. So maybe her dress is just, you know, for her to perform or whatever. So I thought that was kind of cute. And then she has her own little like vanity and everything so she can get ready for her show. And then she actually has like a secret passage from her dresser room to the stage. She's actually the only one who can access it. She has a door that is in her dressing room. She can get through the door from the entry room and then that's locked for everybody but her. So only she can access the stage and everything. Thought it was really, really cute. So this is me like trying to do the outside and I don't know how well it worked out. I actually went back inside the build and all of the garages were like able to be seen from the inside. So I ended up having to change it up quite a bit, but I thought it was kind of a cute idea to put this CC on the outside where it kind of like is supposed to look like it's exposed brick that is vandalized or whatever. I don't know. Anyways, y'all, that is gonna be it for me today. I really, really hope that you all enjoyed. Please let me know what you thought in the comments down below, and I will see you all in my very next video. Bye, loves. Mwah.
So long, standing on the sidelines, what now I hear something that sounds like a love song from the birds in the